Welcome back. Now let's continue the discussion. I'm now being joined on the program by Patrick Agwembo, who is a security consultant and the CEO of Security Watch Africa Initiative. Thank you very much, Patrick, for joining us on the program once again. This incident that happened at Burning Yari at that federal government girls' college, does it surprise you? Because this time, from what we have gathered, everyone knew that this attack was going to happen. Everyone knew even days before the attack happened. And then policemen were stationed at the school, yet the attack still happened.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that the attack still happened. If you remember, last time we spoke, I said many of these attacks, sadly, may still occur. And it's because over time, these attacks have been going on, and those responsible to check it and not doing what they should do. And the bandits are finding it to be very lucrative. So they will always make every effort to ensure that they carry out these acts. Information I gathered was that the number of the bandits that came for that operation overwhelmed the police that were on ground. That is one thing that we must note, because we don't have enough policemen. And the information is also is that the number of police at that school were just two at that hour of the day. And so there's nothing those policemen could have done to prevent such a sad incident. So I'm not surprised. We said it earlier, and it will still happen. More action must be taken by the security services and the communities themselves.
Now, what is quite surprising in all of this is that if the bandits could be bold enough to attack a school that has security personnel in place, then what then is the fate of those that haven't got security personnel? Because quite a number of security analysts have made the point that we need to have security personnel on ground in some of these schools. And so this time, you have, even if there were just two security personnel, but at least they were armed. And you would think that since there was information that this attack was going to happen, that there would have been some kind of preparation for a backup, just in case.
No, Deji, the sad situation we found ourselves is that I'm sure you know that you must have visited some of all these police stations in rural communities and to be able to find out what they are having. I'm sure that those policemen may not have enough firepower to be able to withstand these people. These bandits are moving about with assault rifles and sometimes grenades. So really, those police will not be able. Information also is that there were exchange of gunfire, but from how many number of policemen, there's no way they will be able to withstand the menacing bandits that came. So it also shows that they are getting embolded in the mall now. And the number of policemen or security services we have is not enough to cover all the schools. I have also said that it's not about putting security men in the schools that will solve this problem. It's more of intelligence to be able to stop it from happening, because these bandits, before they strike in that school, they must have come to that school, or they must have gotten information from...
In this case, the intelligence was even common knowledge. The intelligence was available. I mean, we've heard from the people of the community that, look, they all knew that this was going to happen. That it was public knowledge there.
Yeah.
So you begin to wonder, what kind of intelligence would you need that would be better than that, if that intelligence was available and nothing was done to prevent the attack from happening?
You know, like we also say in security, there's different from intelligence. There are different shades of intelligence. There's what we call actionable intelligence. If somebody comes and say a school will be attacked in Lagos, and like it was, the information was not, it's not that school particularly. People were just insinuating it that there will be attack on schools in Kebbi State. And because of that, police deployed to the strength they have. Kebbi State Police Command do not have more than 3,000 to 4,000 policemen to be able to cover the large land vast, the vast land in that state. So they don't have enough manpower, even if the manpower, how many arms and ammunition do they have? So it goes beyond that. It goes to the fact that if the intelligence was credible enough, and if it was processed, nobody knows the particular school that they was going to be attacked. And they chose those schools that are in remote areas. Brini Yauri is somewhere I've passed through on my way, and I know that it's one of the isolated communities. But if it's a, since it's a federal government school, they should have known that that is a prime place to be attacked, and should have called in the military, sadly, to be able to position and prevent such attacks. I think this is a wake-up call, really, because it's very obvious that these people are not relenting. In as much as I believe that security services have not done much, I believe that it's time for them to tighten up what they have. They should do by strengthening up the areas and all the schools. A lot of gaps are existing in our security system that needs to be worked seriously.
Do you think it's a mere coincidence that this attack happened at a time when the president was visiting Maiduguri, the Borno state capital? Do you think it was deliberate and that the bandits were trying to send a message?
No, I think it's just coincidental. It's not deliberate, because I'm sure that the bandits must have planned this and done their recce. They must have, the information had started filtering in since about 5-6 days ago that there will be attack in one of the schools, but nobody knew the particular school. So it's coincidental. It's not deliberate, really.
And let's talk about that visit by the president. How important do you think the visit is?
Yeah, it's very important. It's very important, and I myself just got back from Borno State. I was there for 4 to 5 days last week. I just got back, and I know that the situation in that place demanded maybe the president to visit, because there is need to totally flush out the remnant of these terrorists from the state entirely. The state is safe. I went beyond Maiduguri to some other communities around, and I can tell you that his going there is to help to cement what has been achieved by the security forces. And like he said, it's not about brute force. It's not about security forces themselves doing the work. There is more work to be done by the people, because this is an ideological war. It's not conventional warfare. It's an ideological war, which means that it will need the people to help to solve it finally.
And just before I let you go, I mean, since you've just come back from the North, is that's my degree to be precise, from what you have seen on the ground, would you say the Nigerian military is consolidating on its effort now to ending the insurgency?
Yeah, I think I will score them 60%, because they have done the area from what I find out, because there are some areas that people hitherto could not travel, commercial vehicles could not travel without escorts, but they can travel very far as 400 kilometers. Borno State is very far. And one of the things that have also helped is the infighting within the insurgents between Boko Haram and the ISWAP group. It has helped them. They are more preoccupied within themselves now, and that has given a bit of an edge to our security forces. And that is why Mr. President visited, to be able to push them now to go ahead and possibly finish the military aspect of the war. Then why the other aspect, which is the civilian aspect of it, will start.
Patrick Agwambu, thank you very much for joining us on the program as always.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll take a short break and we'll be right back.
Opinions are free, facts are sacred, but truth is universal.
How, in practical terms, can we, for instance, de-escalate the tension?
President must see himself as the president of the Federal Republic.
We know where the enemy is. Three places. The Lake Chad Basin, the border area between Nigeria and Cameroon, and then the Sambisa Forest.
On DEJI360, we give you a complete dose of everything. Opinion, facts, and undiluted truth.
I hardly believe what politicians say in this part of the world.
A new Nigeria is possible, a future is possible.
We delve into the issues, dissect it so that you can understand it, use it to take action.
I don't think there's any need for any governor to look for grant for ranching.
DEJI360, dissecting the issues.